people, so in this video let us look at disaster cycle. What is this disaster cycle? So basically disaster, you know what a disaster is? It is nothing but any occurrence. Okay, disaster is any occurrence. Okay, it is any occurrence that causes damage, ecological disruption, loss of human life or deterioration of health and health services on a scale sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside of the affected community or area. So basically, it is any occurrence that causes damage, loss of human life or deterioration of health and health services on such a scale, okay, which is sufficient to warrant an extraordinary response from outside. So this is the disaster. Okay, this is a disaster. So when you give examples of disaster, what will you give? So they can be like hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes, right? Floods, volcanoes, all these can be natural disasters. Then you can have some other technological disasters like chemical releases, right? Power outages there in this place, or natural gas explosions, etc. Right? Then there are other disasters which are man-made, like terror attacks can happen, riots, mass shootings, right? So these become disasters. Now let us move on to the disaster cycle. What exactly is this disaster cycle? It is a cyclic management. Okay, so following a disaster you have these cyclic events, right? Management events. So basically, where is the disaster here? The disaster has been shown here. So right, this is the impact. So this is the disaster impact, and immediately you have the response, right? So you have the disaster here, then you have the response. So basically, first what will you do? You will search, rescue, give first aid, right? So the uninjured survivors themselves, they will come to help, right? It is the uninjured survivors who come to immediate help. Who will help you? The person who is there, right there, but he didn't get injured, you got injured. So they will help. This is the immediate help. These survivors are organized. They come to rescue and provide first aid. So they will be providing what? First aid. Then you have something called as field care. So food has to be provided in the place of disaster. So you will have to provide tents, right? Or they can live in some schools or community halls, because these schools and community halls, nobody will be there, right? So you can take this as makeshift homes, right? Then you'll have to provide health resources, volunteers, police, home guards. These people are deployed to these places, right? Then you will have an inquiry center to respond to the queries of these people, to respond to the queries of patients, the friends, their relatives, their family members, etc. So you will have to also identify dead people, guys. Dead people will have to be identified, and adequate mortuary space will also have to be given. Okay, then under this response itself, you have something called as triage. So we have a separate video on triage. So basically triage or triage is something like you will prioritize the treatment, right? Based on who is severely injured, right? That will be red. Priority one is red color. These are critically ill patients. So if you have seen the triage video, so if you remember the triage video, right? So priority one, immediate care, critically ill patients, red color, right? Priority two is yellow, moderately ill people, right? Then priority three is green. They'll have ambulatory patients with minimal risk, and priority four will be the dead people, black, okay? Or moribund patients, that means they are going to die, okay? So that was triage. This also comes under this response part. Okay, in response, what did you see? First aid, right? Field care, you'll send a lot of volunteers. Then you saw triage. Okay, then you have tagging. So once you do triage, you will give them tags, right? Which will identify them based on the red or yellow or green, etc. Also, you will give to the survivors, you can give tags with their identification, gender, contact details, etc. Okay. Then identification of dead. Here another thing is there, identification of the dead. So that we already saw in the beginning, the dead bodies need to be removed. You need adequate mortuary space, and people should be given the time to mourn, etc. Right? So guys, we are still in the first step itself, the response. In response, there are some more things that you should know. Primary phase, secondary phase, and tertiary. Primary is where you give first aid, medical care. Secondary is the transportation, sanitation, immunization you will do. And the tertiary cleanup, food, clothing, shelter, assistance, social service, all that will come. Okay. Now let us move on to the second part here, recovery. In that we are talking about rehabilitation. Okay. So guys, we are moving on to the second one here, rehabilitation. So in rehabilitation, what will you see? In this rehabilitation recovery, basically water supply you will give, then you will give sanitation, personal hygiene, food safety, vector control. So if there is some flood and all, you will have to do vector control, right? Then food safety, then sanitation, personal hygiene, all this you will write, guys. So then you have here, they have written reconstruction also. Okay, then let us go to mitigation. We are going to the next one here, guys, mitigation. So under mitigation, what have they written? Prevention. Okay. So mitigation is something like prevention where you're trying to lessen the effects of an emergency. Now let us say a software company, right? So you will have disaster mitigation. What they do is they don't store data in one place. They store data in multiple places. Okay. So that they can recover. Right? If this server is gone, they will recover from another server. So this is disaster mitigation. They make sure that all the employees are not seated in one place. All of the employees who have to go somewhere are not traveling in the same aeroplane. So that is a disaster mitigation. So such mitigation measures will be done so that if an emergency occurs, first of all, you stop the emergency from occurring. If it occurs, the effects should be less. So you should be able to recover. Right? You should be able to lessen the effects of the emergency. So is this clear? That will be mitigation. Lastly, they are talking about preparedness. Preparedness is early warning, etc. So you know that if a tsunami is coming, right, you will prepare, you will evacuate the people. So you know that there has an earthquake has occurred somewhere in the sea. So you are getting the warning of a tsunami. So you evacuate the people. Flood warning, you evacuate the people. So those will be preparedness, right? Consists of strengthening the capacity of a country to manage all types of emergencies. Okay. So you should be able to provide assistance to the victims, bring back life to normal, etc. So that will be preparedness. So what will they do here? They will keep all the food kits ready, right? Lot of food kits would have been prepared and kept by the government. Lot of blankets, lot of helicopters will be trained in such situation, how to drop the food packets, how to provide shelter, temporary tents, what should be there in some relief packet, right? Some relief packet will provide candles, etc. because they will not have light, right? So all such things, these are preparedness, okay? So hope you have understood, guys, what have we been trying to understand in this video, disaster cycle. So remember to draw the cycle in the exam, okay? Just take a quick look at it. So here you will put a disaster. After a disaster, you will show response, immediate response and whatever that is. Then recovery, mitigate, prepare. Okay. This is hopefully this preparedness won't end in disaster always. Okay. That is all in disaster cycle now. Okay. See you in the next video, guys. Bye bye.